Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Open Source Tonight. Folks, today what I want to show you how to do is create a username in Linux that you can use for things like SFTP or for things like FTP or basically anything else you want, but does not allow for a login. So that means the user cannot SSH in with their password and username and get logged in as a session, or they cannot set in front of the actual machine and do that on a TTY or a GUI session. Okay, so let's get right on into it. It's really easy. We're going to add a user. So this will work on any Linux distribution of your choice. I'm going to make a user called test user. And now I'm going to actually set its shell. Now its shell is going to be a very interesting one. USR slash sbin slash no login. So this is the thing that's going to run whenever they try to log in remotely or locally. And that right there is going to let them not log in, right? That's literally what it's for. No login is pretty self-explanatory. So we're going to hit enter on this. And, oh, I forgot, I already created the user's home directory before. Let me just delete that. I've already done this video before. You're getting a little behind the scenes. Oh, probably help if I did that. All right. So, let me go and I will delete the user again. Okay. Anyway, but so now if we come back here and we actually run this again... Okay, it's still upset that the mailbox file already existed. But again, this was something I already created. So there we go. We have our user. And now, if we wanted to, say, log into it, let's try su and then test user. It's going to ask me for a password. There is no password, but if I try hitting enter, eventually it's just going to time out here and get upset at me. Yeah, see, it's not going to let me do it. So it's not going to work. So let's say that I actually go to the next step. What if, you know, because we do want this to be, let's say, able to use like FTP, for example. Here's how we're going to do that. I'm going to just do passwd and set my user's password here. So I'll put in sudo passwd and then the username. Now I'm going to come in here and type a password in. It's not a secure password, but that's okay. All right, and now it's updated. And just like that, we have a password. Now, you might say, well, now I have a password, so surely this should work great. It will not. Let's try it. This account is currently not available. So there you go. But now, if I wanted to use something like FTP, etc., things like that, this would work because that user is only set to not be able to log in, if that makes sense. Anyway, folks, hope you enjoyed today's video on Open Source Tonight. And until next time, everybody, thanks for watching, and goodbye. And action.